Welcome. In this session, we would talk about how to incorporate case studies into answer writing. A lot of time we take case studies, but many students are unable to understand where do we actually put those case studies. So today we would be talking about a very recent case study of today itself, and that is Hurricane Beryl. But before we move into Hurricane Beryl and the science behind it, let's understand where all this case study can be applied. So if a question pertains to climate change, global warming, food security, infrastructure issues, health and standards of living, coastal countries, then small island developing countries, La Nina, trade winds, El Nino, if it pertains to any phenomena which pertains to the cyclones or the hurricanes in particular, or formation of tropical cyclones, in all those cases we can apply this case study. So let's talk about the Hurricane Beryl, which actually was seen at the coast of Zambia today itself, and this has been declared as a category 5 hurricane. Now, under the Saffir-Simpson hurricane scale, the categories range from 1 to 5, 1 being the least severe and 5 being the most catastrophic of those. Now, what usually happens in an ocean is the ocean actually warms. Now, this warming, specifically when we are targeting, this Hurricane Beryl has struck the coast of Caribbean Islands, Jamaica. So, we'll be moving on to that in a while. But let's understand the science behind tropical cyclone for the first. So, these tropical cyclone actually start to build up when oceans become warm. Typically, in the regions of North Atlantic, this is seen sometime during the month of August, where category 5 hurricanes can be witnessed. However, this is the first time that this record has been seen in the month of early July, that is the beginning of the July. We have category 5 hurricane which has been witnessed. The reason being, for 14 consecutive years, May of 2024 was one of the worst, or the warmest we could say, ocean temperatures in the regions of North Atlantic. Now, as we mentioned, this category 5 means the hurricane would reach the speed of nearly 250 to 260 kilometers per hour, and that is a catastrophic one with heavy rainfall, flash floodings that could be witnessed. If we focus on to the path through which this cyclone is actually, this hurricane is moving, it started as a tropical storm, moving as a tropical cyclone, category 1, category 2, category 3, and at the coast of Jamaica turning into category 5. It would slowly and gradually reduce again, and by the time it hits the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico or affects the parts of United States, this would turn again to a tropical storm or a tropical cyclone. It is as predicted. So this is the pattern of how a cyclone moves or a hurricane moves, right? Now, this undergoes series of rapid intensification. This Hurricane Beryl has been intensified by few of those. One intensification has been witnessed due to the warming oceans, as we already discussed. So even in the regions of Jamaica and Haiti, mainly in the regions of Hacipelenio, there has been tremendous devastations that have been witnessed. Warming of the oceans, the second important part is the anticipated La Nina, that is the cooling of the region. And the third important one is the reduced trade winds. Now, all of these have intensified the Hurricane Beryl much before it could actually have been seen. So, power lines have been affected, infrastructures have been affected, houses have been damaged, and specifically the carbon pollution which is done by other nations is affecting the small island developing nations, what is called as the SIDS nations, right? So here we understand that what is required for warming. Now, for warming, it is believed that a temperature of more than 27 degrees Celsius or nearly what we call as 80 degree Fahrenheit, extending up to a depth of 150 meters below the surface, with low vertical wind shear are some of the primary conditions which are required for a hurricane to intensify. Now, once it intensifies, the region it affects becomes widespread. So, according to the National Ocean Atmospheric Studies, it is believed that 85% more chances of above normal hurricanes would be witnessed for 2024. So 2024 would be a year which would witness 85% above normal hurricanes. That means around 17 to 25 hurricanes would be witnessed, which are usually some on an average around 14, right? So the average has increased from 14 to nearly 17 to 25, which is a huge number. And of these 17 to 25, it is believed that 4 to 7 hurricanes would turn into category 5 or category 4. That means they could be highly disastrous, which usually averages at around 3. Now, with these many phenomena into thing, we have seen that Jamaica recently imposed Section 26 of the Disaster Risk Management Act to protect the territory and the region. And in one of the recent addresses, it has been said that nearly whole of the island has become homeless. The event had been highly disastrous and detrimental to the region. So when we are talking about case studies, we can incorporate case studies like this across various categories, as we have discussed. So understanding the concept and the right place to apply is really important, specifically when you are targeting with contemporary case studies. So let's say your exams begin in September, and if you are able to bring out a case study which is very close to your examination, somewhere in the month of August or September itself, it would be fantastic. So make sure that you are able to bring in the right selection and place it at a right place. Now, what I want to emphasize here again is this case study could go in all of these topics, but the way it would be incorporated would differ significantly, because when we are talking about climate change, when we are talking about global warming, we have to emphasize the fact that because of rapid intensification, this hurricane has occurred prior to when it is usually expected, correct? But when we are talking about trade winds, cyclones, La Nina, we would focus more on the scientific aspects, how it intensifies, at what temperature, what ocean depth is required, which scales to measure it, right? So those things become different. When we are talking about small island developing nations, we mainly focus on to the pollution being caused by the developed nations and the impact being borne by the developing, especially the coastal and the small island nations, right? So again, there is a difference in how you would place the same answer in this case. And then if there is a question related to food security, you can emphasize that a small island developing nation is really struggling with food security if there are series of hurricanes impacting those regions, and how there would be a lean month in food production for a period of nearly 5 to 7 months if this cycle actually intensifies and these kinds of hurricanes intensify, correct? So placing the right answer in the right way at the right place is really, really important. And that's what you practice when you are talking about answer writing. So stay tuned for a lot of updates from our side. And definitely, if you have any questions or queries, follow below and do join.